Good day from Chem Help ASAP. If you've been watching this playlist, we've covered all these different reactions, SN2s, SN1s, E1s. We haven't talked about E2 reactions on alcohol. So let's see why that is. So at the top of the screen, I have an alcohol. This is a secondary alcohol, and we treat it with a nice strong base. That's the Q for very likely E2 reaction, and I've even drawn an E2 product, the alkene. But the fact is, this will be a no reaction. Nothing will happen in this. We will not get an E2 reaction. In fact, just to be clear, let's put an X through there. We won't get an E2. And the reason is we don't have a leaving group. Well, that hasn't been a big problem with alcohols. We can always make a leaving group. So let's propose a solution. Let's say we want to take our alcohol and let's treat it with an acid. So step one, let's make a leaving group. So we'll just treat it with sulfuric acid. I'm not going to draw the mechanism, but what we'll do is we'll protonate our alcohol. Now we have a leaving group. So let's say this is a point. Now we'll just add some base. And sodium hydroxide could be sodium ethoxide, whatever. Why wouldn't this work? Well, the problem is we just mixed a really strong base with a molecule that has really acidic hydrogens. Our base is just going to pull a hydrogen off of our oxygen. It's not going to go after a beta hydrogen. So we stuck the proton on the oxygen initially. We will rip it right back off the oxygen. So that's why this will not work. This will not do an E2. We'll just do a deprotonation and get our starter material back. Okay, well, what other leaving group options do we have? We could take our alcohol and we could, in a step, we could treat it with tosyl chloride. Tosyl chloride and pyridine. That would make a leaving group. Now our leaving group doesn't have any of these excess acidic hydrogens, and this will work fine. We can, in a second step, treat this with sodium hydroxide, and we would indeed get our E2 product. Now, tosylate, I think when you first learn tosylates, they seem a little exotic, but you don't have to do a tosylate. We could have instead reacted this with PBr3, and instead of making the tosylate, we would have made a bromide. Yeah, that's fine. We just need a leaving group to do the E2 reaction. So you can do E2 reactions on alcohols, but you have to first to convert that alcohol into a leaving group. And we can't do this through protonation. We need to convert it to a halide or a tosylate, and then we can perform an E2 just as we learned with the alkyl halides. So you can do it, but first you have to make a stable leaving group for the E2 reaction.